Hello, everyone. Today is November 4th, 2021. I believe today is Diwali. So happy Diwali, everybody. Festival of Lights.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. That's right.
So we're doing holiday cards. And I was inspired by BJ last week with her three holidays on one card. I'm a universalist, which means that I love all religions. So I thought it would be fun to put together a card that had more than just the three American religions, that had a more of a worldview. So I started creating something this morning.
La, la, la. Hey, Candace, yeah. This is the card I got. Can you see it? And it's got everything on it.
I love it.
Oh, that's great.
What does the inside say?
She put a word search on top. I don't know if you can see, I got kind of a glare. She put a word search on top. And then she did a little thingy on the bottom. But yeah, I love the top. I don't know where she got it, but it's super cute.
That is super cute. Yeah. So super, super cute. But I love the three panel card idea. I just wanted to add a few more holidays. So today is Diwali. So this card is going to go out after Diwali. But I love the whole idea of the Festival of Lights. Diwali is a Hindu holiday that celebrates the new year for the Hindu calendar. But it's also celebrated by Buddhists. So Diwali hits, half the world, 2 billion people or something.
Right.
There are no Muslim holidays in November or December this year that I could find. There's Christmas, there's Festivus for the rest of us. Happy Hanukkah, which starts on the same day as Thanksgiving this year, New Year's and Thanksgiving. And then at the very top, it just says, may your holiday season be merry and bright. So I just threw that together this morning because I was inspired by BJ.
Thank you.
BJ inspired me. It's a 15x7 panel. I used a photo template from Elements. So in the Elements, you can find, come on.
Is that what you need for the three panel, 15x7?
15x7, 15 inches wide by 7 inches tall. Okay. So I just grabbed a grid that had seven picture grids. And I just used it as is, didn't do anything fancy. And then I just started searching for photos that floated my boat. I actually had to make the Festivus. So this is the Seinfeld circle with the Festivus in the Seinfeld font that the closest I could find. Do you guys know what Festivus for the rest of us is? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. All right, so it's a Seinfeld thing. It's George Costanza's father created this Festivus for the rest of us as a holiday for people who weren't Christian or Jewish or Muslim. The holiday for everybody else who doesn't celebrate those things. So that was, it was created by Seinfeld, but then people started to actually celebrate it. So there's the airing of grievances. So it's a holiday to air your grievances. There are a lot, there's like 35 different holidays in November and December that are of a religious nature. So I just picked six that could cover the broadest spectrum of people. So anyway, I think I just threw it together, but I like it.
Very nice.
Candace, I like it.
Candace, so, which of those did you use? Which of those layouts?
It is very, very bottom.
Here. So you pick the layout and then you say it, tell it the size. How do you?
Yeah. So which layout was it? It was towards the bottom. I looked for one that had seven panels. So I just kept counting panels till I found one I liked. So I'm just going to grab one right here. So here's one. And it just, you click on it and it fits the space. So this has room for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 photos.
So where do you tell it the size?
It just automatically, if you click on it, it will automatically fill the space.
You set up your card. Are you on the free version or the paid version, BJ, for Canva?
Oh, are you talking about making your card from scratch?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you see my screen still? It's changed to the Canva homepage. Yes?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Over here, it says custom size.
Custom size.
And then you click on that and you change it to inches. And you change the height. I'm sorry, the width to 15 and the height to 7.
Okay.
It'll give you a 15x7 graphic. So 15x7. And then you can just play with it. Let's have fun.
Got it.
Because this is fun. So you can do all sorts of fun things. So much fun. So much fun. Okay. So that's the inside. Let's delete this. That's going to be the inside of the card. I'm really happy with that. So then I was like, okay, what am I going to put on the front of the card? And I just went to templates and I typed in holiday photo greeting card. And I found this one here. And I was like, well, I don't like the green background. So I changed it to cream. So I'm going to, and I love that it says warm wishes from our family to yours, because when you open it up, it's got all the holidays, right? So my family is going out today, the three of us all together. I'm taking my selfie stick and I'm going to get a picture of us today. I was looking through my photos and I do not have a photo of all three of us. Okay. So, and then the inside, so that's going to be the front of the card. And then the inside will be that panel that I just showed you. So that'll be the inside. Then you got this flap, right? You have this flap. Mm-hmm. So on that flap, I was going to just do, here's what we did this year. Dorothy graduated from college and Candace and Shane went on vacation, right? So that's all that happened to us. And then we had three cats at the cat. Oh, you know what? I'll take a picture. We just got the cat. I just had this idea. Okay. So have you guys seen the litter robot? Have you seen the litter robot? Do you know what I'm talking about? It's a litter box that self cleans. It's this giant globe thing. It's big circle and you put the cats just got a litter robot. The three updates will be Dorothy graduated from college. Shane and Candace went to Nantucket. The cats got a litter robot.
Put some bacon in there.
That's our update on the so that'll be on the flap. And then on the back of the card, I'll have to come up with some sort of branding for the back of the card. All right. So that's what we're doing for our three panel card. Okay, for the holidays.
Can you repeat, and my tardiness, but can you repeat what's on the inside?
Yes, the inside is six holidays plus a may your season be merry and bright.
You could do a card like that every month with six different weird days to celebrate.
That is an awesome idea, Di.
Yeah.
And the thing about the three panel cards is that they're thick, right? When they're in the envelope, they are thick. So people are going to open them first because they want to know what's in them.
And it doesn't cost anymore.
Exactly. So that's why I like sending the three panel cards, because they're thick and they make a
bigger impact. So I just watched the video of Cody doing the walkthrough of the bulk orders. So you can order like 10 or 15 of them for those people that you're like, oh my God, I forgot to send them a card and here they are in person. Just stick them in your purse.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's going to be great. And they're $1.25 right now. It's a really good price.
I'm going to do that for my daughter's thank you cards for the wedding. So we can put a picture on the front and have them sent here.
Now we're going to take that three panel card and we're going to turn it into a greeting card. So I like to do my holiday cards as campaigns because I'm done with this card. So let's save it. Always download your images for print. If you're going to print it like in a greeting card, it's a PNG. And if you're going to use it on a website, do a JPEG because it's a smaller file and will take up less space. PNGs take up about twice as much space as JPEGs. And smaller the file, the faster it loads. We're going to create a campaign. So we go to campaigns over on the left column and then click on my campaigns over here. And then we make a new one by clicking on the plus sign. And we'll call this 2021 Festivus for the rest of us. And this is obviously it's going to go out in November and not December. So now we're going to do a build your own card. Actually, you know what? We're not going to do a build your own card. I'm going to look and see if there is a holiday card that's a photo drop card that I could just drop a picture of my family in. So I'm going to customize it. I'm going to make it a three panel card. It's not eligible for a bulk send because it's three panels. And you can change the paper to satin or pearl. I just had a client send out 90 plus big cards on satin paper. Yes. $10 Starbucks gift cards inside.
Ka-ching.
Isn't that a nice? That's someone who gets it. Mm-hmm. Someone who gets it. So it's going to be a 3-panel card on standard paper because I personally like the glossy paper. All right. So I don't have a picture of my family right now, but I'm just going to go over here and grab a picture of Shane and I in front of John Adams' birthplace. So John Adams was born in that house. So there's Shane and I in front of, I mean, that's not what the photo I'm going to use. I'm just using it as a placeholder. Okay. So then on the inside of the card, I'm going to upload. I'm going to click on the layout button and I'm going to upload. I'm going to click on the layout button and then select the full bleed image. Click on the circle to upload the photo. And then I'm going to upload that photo. And it's going to take a minute because it's a very large photo that's high quality. This is the 15x7 photo. And when you upload it, you just click it, press down with your mouse and drag it over until it lines up. And so now it looks like one picture across all 3 panels. And it's groovy. Groovy. Okay, so that's the inside of the inside panel. And then the flappy flap. I'm going to do a custom panel from Canva that says basically what we did in 2021 stuff, right? So that'll be a panel. And then on the back, I'll put some sort of holiday branding or whatnot. You guys like that? I made that last year. I think it's hilarious.
Oh my goodness.
You can probably find that meme on Google.
I love it.
Okay, so then you save you add the photo to the you add the card to the campaign down here. And sometimes you can change the date so that you can send it now. You can click send now, but it doesn't go out until later. When I send this, I'm going to want it to go out immediately. So I'm not going to do that. But if I did want to do that, you edit the card and you can change the send delay to send on a specific day. You can change the paper and you can add a gift. I'm not going to do that because when I do send this, I'm going to want it to go out immediately. And then to send it, you can either go like here, select all, create. If you're smart, you put everybody in a group called holiday cards. These are all the people who sent me a holiday card last year. So that's how you send it. And then you click ready to send. And if you don't want to send it, there's this fancy dancy cancel order button. For those of you who are watching the replay, let's talk about pricing. So let's click on my head, go to account, go over here to pricing. So you don't need a subscription. You can just buy cards one at a time, or you can buy in bulk and they're printed, stuff scanned and mailed for you. Or if you do the bulk option, which there's two ways to describe bulk. Bulk is that we have the group sends where we send the cards for you. And then the bulk cards where you design your card, we send out cards and then we print it and mail you the cards with envelopes so that you can mail them yourself. Okay. So those are $1.50. They're on sale right now for $1.25. And you can order a minimum of 10 or up to 400 of those. At $1.25, that is super cost effective. That's $125 for 100 cards. You're not going to find that price from most of the other print on demand greeting card companies. Okay. And then we have the $37 card a day plan, which includes 30 group sends. A group send is where you create a card online and you send it to multiple people. This does not include postage. So $37 plus postage, you can send 30 cards. This is a subscription, but there's no contract. So you can sign up for it on Tuesday and cancel it on Wednesday. All right. Use all your cards, cancel on Wednesday. So there's no obligation with it. So $37 for 30 cards. These are printed, stuff stamped and mailed for you. So it's $1.25 right now on sale for those 30 cards, or $37 for 30 if you want us to mail them for you. Then on the $97 subscription, that also includes 30 group sends, but it also includes unlimited single cards. So if you wanted to create an individualized Christmas card for each member of your family, and you have 100 people in your family, you can send 100 of those, including postage, for $97. The $147 plan is the plan I'm on. That includes 100 system cards a month. So I can send 100 cards a month included in my 147. Does not include postage. It's $1.47 a card. Printed stuff stamped and mailed for me. And that client that I just told you about who sent out the 90 plus big cards with the gift cards in them, they're on the 247 because they sent out 400 or 500 cards total, right? So $247 a month includes 250 system sends. This is a great option for businesses like the graphic design company who are sending a lot of cards. Or my mother and father, who used to send about 250 Christmas cards every year. And it wasn't them who sent those Christmas cards. It was me. Mm-hmm. Licking those stamps. Remember when we had to lick stamps? Licking those stamps, licking those envelopes, signing those cards. Oh, my sisters and I would sit there. And my mom collected people the way that other people collect collectibles. I mean, Aunt Rita knows. My mom knew people everywhere. So when we sent out Christmas cards, there were a lot of them. Anyway, that would have saved our little tongues a lot of licking when we were doing Christmas cards for my mom and dad. Anyway, so those are our options. We can print them for you for $1.25 each, currently on sale, or $1.50 when the sale is over. I'm not sure when the sale ends, which is still super cost effective, still beats the prices of most of the other print on demand companies, or 30 for 37. Or 100 for 147, or 250 for 247. Remember, these are subscriptions, but you can cancel them anytime. Okay, so that's pricing. So let's talk about uploading your contacts. I did a tutorial video. I don't know if you guys saw it, but my client in LA who just sent those cards, he had his street and city and state and zip, maybe it was just city, state, and zip all in one line. So I did a tutorial video on how to separate those columns. This is post-separation. So I made this fake spreadsheet to show them how to do it, but I'm going to use this fake spreadsheet to explain to you how spreadsheets work. So you need to separate first and last name, street, city, state, zip. You don't need country unless you're sending to another country. And then from here, from the spreadsheet, the upload spreadsheet, you can actually create groups. So if you want to put your 2021 holiday list as an upload, single upload now, you can do that and put them in a group called 2021 holiday. And the other thing that you can do is you can put spouse, and then you can also add birthdays and anniversaries in the spreadsheet, and those will get uploaded. So let's see what happens when we upload this. Send out cards like CSV spreadsheets, so file, and they also like text. They don't upload Excel. So you have to save it as a text or a CSV. So I'm going to save this as a text tab delimited right here. Text tab delimited sample spreadsheet with spouse. All right. So then I'm going to close it, and I'm going to go back over to send out cards and click on relationships, and then import contacts up here, this pink button. Mm-hmm. And then I'm going to click or drag your CSV file here to upload. I'm going to click on it because I don't have an Apple. I have a desktop, a PC. I have a PC, so I can't drag. I can only click. So I'm going to click, and then I'm going to find that spreadsheet.
So why can't you drag?
You only Apple can drag.
I dragged.
Do you? Maybe it's just me. Sample spreadsheet with spouse. So here's that. Go. And then I'm going to open it.
Right.
And then I'm going to match the fields. All right. So address one is street. See, it's this is not assigned to street. So I have to make sure it matches. So I'm going to go down here and make sure that street matches address one. And then state looks like it's not assigned either. So I'm going to go down there and make sure that state is assigned. Country looks like it's assigned, and then make sure the group is assigned, right? And then you got to go and match the spouse first name. All right. What else do you guys want to, we've got 10 minutes. What else do you going to want to know holiday card related?
To make a QR code, what I'm going to do is I'm in a Dotsie group. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a postcard for my Dotsie group. And then on the back, I want to make a QR code. For I have a 20% coupon off of Pawtree. Does that seem tacky, or is that a nice little gift?
I would put it on the back of the card.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna do.
Yeah. And you know, you could do, make a card back that has a QR code that says, you know, save whatever on the 20% on the back of the card. And you can do that in Canva. It's under, you get home, all your folders.
Yeah, I saw it yesterday. I had tools. I did a host tutorial on Canva again because I know it, but I really want to get deep into it. So I forgot where the lady did. Yeah, there it is. Okay. So I'll go ahead and do that. That was my question. If I thought that was kind of tacky, but it's like a little gift, you know?
Yeah. On the back of the card, it's okay.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. That's so, where I would put it.
And if you're sending somebody a birthday, like a birthday card, and you want to give them something for, I wouldn't give a coupon as a birthday gift, but if you wanted to give somebody like a gift card from Amazon and you didn't want to buy it from Send Out Cards because you don't want to pay the $3 activation fee, you just wanted to buy the Amazon gift card from Amazon directly, you can take the Amazon QR code for a gift and put it in a card as, and this is the QR code for $20, you know, 25 gift cards for Amazon.
Cool.
And I'm sure there's other gift card options that you can do that too. But once you create the QR code, you can use it in a design, which is kind of cool.
I have two different clients that I have a birthday birthday QR code that I put inside their cards that say for a special message. And one of them, it's the Beatles, happy birthday. They say it's your birthday. I send that. And I do that for two different clients. And then, so the QR code that I generated, I did it on QR Monkey. I made it in their logo colors. Uh-huh. And then I also did, it has like a little birthday cake in the middle.
Cute. So the QR, so the message says, scan this for a special birthday message from us. And then you open it up and it goes to YouTube and plays with you. You say it's your birthday. Uh-huh. That's a great idea.
I like that.
There are a lot of ways to use QR codes, coupons, links to videos. It's fun. It's a lot of fun. I love Christy's idea of the Beatles' birthday. That's
really, I just got one. A friend of mine just made me one that takes directly to send a free card.
Oh, perfect. Guy, that's a great idea. That is such a good idea.
My brain goes.
Five holidays to celebrate. The thing is, you have to get it done. Like in February, you need to do March. You know? So the card goes out like February 25th.
If you did you could do it one idea for month and do like it in January as your Happy New Year's card. But I have an Arbonne client who wanted ideas, and I started with holidays related to wellness. That's why that's what that says. But I was looking for like National Bubble Bath Day and National Lipstick Day, and to be able to send to my customers 12 ideas that they can send to their clients to get them to purchase. So that's where my brain went, and this is what I came up with.
I have given that Lipstick Day idea to so many Mary Kay folks, and they've never jumped on it.
Me too.
Their loss.
It's
gold.
You've got to be willing to invest in marketing your business, and Send Out Cards is the lowest marketing cost per ROI out there.
Yeah.
And I was talking to this guy, local guy, who was spending $5,000 a month on billboards, and he couldn't even find the billboards. He's like, I drove by it 10 times before I actually saw it.
Well, and billboards are great only for that brief moment. 2 seconds down the road, you've forgotten, and there's no way you can get the information to contact them.
And a billboard doesn't make you feel warm and fuzzy.
No.
That reminds me, I need to send him an email and remind him it's holiday card time.
What I love is the the advertising on the side of the vehicle, not the back.
Yeah.
Because how many people have time to grab like a shot of the side of a vehicle, but if you have it on the back and you're sitting behind them, you have time usually to snap a shot.
Exactly Sitting at a light, like, oh, let me look around the corner that you're like, really?
Yeah,
how many accidents you get a phone call trying to look on the side? Let me look. Oh,
all right, guys, so bring your guests next week because we're gonna do Christmas cards again, and we're not gonna do the same Christmas card. So if you have an idea for a Christmas card that you want us to work on together, let me know ahead of time so we can do that together. All right. Fun deal.
Ciao.
So I'll see you guys next week. Smooches. Bye, everybody.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.